The Maharlika Investment Fund bill now up for President Marcos's signature. Now, the Office of the Senate President, Juan Miguel Zubiri, says the bill was sent to the President Tuesday after it was signed by House Speaker Martin Romualdez. Marcos earlier said he will immediately sign the controversial measure once he receives it. Now, the bill seeks to create the Philippines' first sovereign wealth fund. It'll be invested in a wide range of assets, including foreign currencies and fixed income instruments, to fund infrastructure and development projects. President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. orders an investigation into the smuggling of onions and other agricultural products. Marcos, who is concurrent agriculture secretary, cited the findings of a House panel probe pointing to the existence of an onion cartel, believed to be behind the surge in onion prices in 2022. Now, the House probe concluded the cartel is operating through the Philippine Vieva Group of companies incorporated. This is to manipulate supply and influence prices. Now, Marcos says illegal activities involving agricultural products can be considered economic sabotage.
I have just given instructions to the DOJ and the NBI to initiate an investigation into the hoarding, smuggling, price fixing of agricultural commodities. And this is stemming from the hearings that were conducted in the House, specifically by Congresswoman Stella Kimbo, and the findings that they came to. And that is why we are going to be very, very strict about finding these people and making sure that they are brought to justice.
A regional trial court approves the Justice Department's request to move alleged drug trafficker Jad Dera out of the detention center of the National Bureau of Investigation. The court issued a commitment order transferring Dera to the Muntinlupa City Jail Mail Dormitory. It also allowed the NBI and the Muntinlupa Jail Warden to escort Dera to an upcoming Senate hearing set today, Wednesday. The DOJ sought Dera's transfer to another facility after he was caught returning from a dinner at a buffet restaurant with six security personnel from the NBI last June. He reportedly bribed NBI officials to enjoy privileges, which include going in and out of detention to travel. Philippine offshore gaming operations, or POGOs, now banned in the city of Valenzuela. The city also suspended new applications for small-town lotteries and online gambling. Valenzuela Mayor Huesca Chelian says the ban aims to maintain order and safeguard the city's residents.
Here in Valenzuela, regardless of what programs na ibabaho namin, we always put in consideration the social and moral impact in the community. Despite of the economic benefits that there might be, or substantial taxes that the POGO has been, the country is benefiting from the POGO operation, makita ho natin yung impact na yon. Kaya po inunahan ko na bago pa dumating po dito sa Valenzuela.
Over now to the tourism campaign mess. Employees of the tourism department throwing their support behind embattled Secretary Cristina Frasco. They gathered Tuesday to back Frasco amid an ongoing controversy on the use of stock footage video from other countries from the new tourism slogan of the Philippines. Lawmakers and mayors from Cebu also issued a manifesto of support for Via Frasco, claiming she is the subject of a demolition job. Frasco is the daughter of Cebu Governor Gwen Garcia. She also served as mayor of Biloan City, Cebu, before her appointment as tourism secretary. Manila's health secretary says President Marcos may formally lift the country's public health emergency declaration due to COVID-19 soon. Secretary Herbosa earlier recommended to lift such status since the World Health Organization no longer sees COVID a global health emergency. He adds many healthcare workers in the country already consider COVID-19 as a disease similar to other illnesses like cough, colds, and influenza.
Sabi niya kasi de facto na parang naka-lift na rin tayo, di ba? Okay. Teka, optional na ang masking, di ba?
But we need that the formal
order. Hindi na in-extend yung ano, di ba? Hindi na in-extend yung state of calamity.
Wala
pang formal. I'm still waiting for the...
Yes.
State Weather Bureau PAGASA officially declares the beginning of the El Nino phenomenon in the Philippines. Jervis Manahan with the full story.
Because of warmer temperature at the equatorial Pacific, PAGASA has officially declared the onset of El Nino. Its effects will be felt in the country starting this October.
Ito na talaga ngayon. Sigurado na tayo kasi talagang mainit na yung dagat. So, ibig sabihin, dire-diretso na ito, nandiyan na yung El Nino sa karagatan, mainit na. Kailangan talaga, seryoso na tayo kasi advisory na ito.
El Nino is a weather phenomenon where surface temperature of the ocean gets warm, usually resulting to lower rainfall levels. Based on PAGASA's assessment of rainfall levels in the past 3 months, Isabela and Tarlac have already experienced dry condition, while Apayao, Kalinga, and Cagayan have experienced a dry spell. Dry condition happens when a place experiences lower rainfall levels for 2 consecutive months, while dry spell happens when rain falls below normal for 3 consecutive months. PAGASA clarifies there will still be rainfall until September, but by the end of January 2024, 26 provinces will already be in drought condition.
Yung pino-forecast po natin na El Nino dyan ay moderate to strong. But this is based on recent condition. Habang nadidevelop at nag-i-strengthen po yung El Nino, so ma-update din natin itong mga potential po na impact for dry spell and drought. May possible po na magbabago yung mga lugar na yan. May possible na may madadagdag na mga lugar. And then yung iba ay possible na hindi po maapektuhan.
Fewer typhoons are expected this year, with 14 expected in the second half of 2023.
Hindi natin nakikita na ito ay tatama sa ating kalupaan kasi mas mahina nga yung ating easterlies, kaya medyo yung track ng bagyo, papasok man siya sa PAR pero hindi siya lalapit masyado. Posible pa rin na may bagyong magla-landfall at yung bagyo na ganito ay tiyak na mas well developed, mas malakas kasi nalagpasan niya yung kanyang character property ay talagang malakas dahil kahit El Nino ay makakatawid siya sa ating makakalapit siya sa lupa.
Because of less rainfall, reduced water supply for households is possible. There may also be less electricity using water for generation.
So ano kaya ang dapat kong gawin ngayon pa lang? So siguro, paano ako makakatulong? Lagi nating binabanggit na in our own little ways, pwede tayong makatulong kung magtitipid din tayo kung anong meron tayo ngayon. Pagtipirin natin ito, and habang may tag-ulan pa, meron pang tubig ulan na bumabagsak, paano kaya natin ito maiipon?
The Department of Agriculture says farmers in other provinces may still plant crops.
Sa ngayon, meron pang pag-uulan, no? Yung mga areas may mga nagtatanim pa. Sa ngayon, may tubig pa na dadating, no? Makaka-harvest ka pa siguro mga late September, late October.
The MWSS says it has already prepared augmentation measures including deep wells and modular water treatment plants.
Sa ngayon po, ang pangako po natin sa National Water Resources Board ay by December is nasa 100 million liters per day yung re-recover po natin. Pero sa ngayon, sir, at the middle of the year ay naka-recover na po tayo na around 38 million liters per day.
Task Force El Nino has also been set to further respond to the phenomenon. Jervis Manahan, ABS-CBN News.
A U.S. think tank accuses the Chinese Coast Guard of pursuing 2 Philippine ships in the West Philippine Sea. Raymond Powell of the Gordon Knot Center says Philippine ships encountered Chinese militia vessels during a June 30th resupply mission to the Navy ship, Sierra Madre. The former U.S. Air Force officer says the Chinese vessels were in a position to intercept the resupply mission. The Philippine Coast Guard spokesperson has yet to confirm the incident. Senator Rizal Tiveros has called China's actions reckless and irresponsible. She says Beijing's continued attempts to occupy Philippine territories show its disrespect for international law. She also urges the Senate to act on a resolution for the Philippine government to raise the maritime dispute before the UN General Assembly.